Now we'll consider the important ideas, tips on how to avoid certain mistakes or how to draw easy diagrams, avoid complex diagrams. All these things we are going to consider. So the topics may not be continuous. One topic may be here and the other topic may be elsewhere. They may not be continuous, all from the same chapter. Okay, so now you see this is Malus law diagram which we have drawn. This is the light which is incident on the first polaroid, then there is the second polaroid. So this is the light coming, first polaroid, second polaroid, observer. Imagine it that way. Okay, so here this is the polarizer, which is basically a polaroid. This is analyzer, which is also a polaroid. Depending on the roles they play, one is called as a polarizer, the other one is called as the analyzer. Now you can see in this, suppose you are asked to draw a diagram to show variation of intensity of the light coming here. That is, after it has passed through both the polaroids, we want to draw the graph between the intensity here and the angle between the two pass axis or transmission axis. This is called a transmission axis. Transmission axis, transmission axis, or pass axis, pass axis. The angle between them, if you take as theta, and the intensity of light in this region, if you take as I. So you may be asked to draw the graph between I and theta, or a graph showing the variation of I with respect to theta. What is theta? Angle between the two. What is I? Intensity here. So commonly you might have come across this, I equal to I naught cos square theta. You draw a cos square graph like this. Now here this is intensity, say I, this is theta. What is intensity? Energy per unit area per second, watt per meter squared is the unit for intensity of light. This is cos square theta graph. But what will you mark here? As per this graph, I naught is the peak value. If you mark I naught here, then I naught should be the intensity here. But you see, the given light is unpolarized. When this light is unpolarized, intensity here should be half the intensity here. So if here the intensity is 2 I naught, then half of this will be I naught, then I will be I naught cos square theta. That graph is fine. Suppose if he has given the intensity here itself is I naught, then here it has to be I naught by 2. What is the idea? Intensity in this region should be half the intensity here, this being unpolarized light. How do you know it is unpolarized light? Look at the symbol, or it may be given in words. So here I naught means I naught by 2, and here you should have I naught by 2, because this relates intensity here and intensity here and this theta. So here it should be I naught by 2, here you should mark I naught by 2. Have you understood that? So why here I naught by 2 unpolarized light? If it is incident in the polarizer, the light when it passes out or passes through the polarizer, it will have an intensity I naught. That arises because of the average value of cos square theta over one full period. So I naught by 2 you will get. Other hand, if it is polarized light here, suppose the light here is polarized, then you see the direction of oscillation is same as the transmission axis. If it's I naught here, this here also it will be I naught. These two directions are same or parallel. So if it is polarized light whose direction of oscillation is same along this, If it is I naught here, then it will be I naught here. Then you will have I naught cos square theta, then here you should write I naught. If it is unpolarized, here it will be I naught by 2. Unpolarized having an intensity I naught, here it will be I naught by 2, here I naught by 2, here also it is I naught by 2. Have you got the idea? Yeah.